In this lifestyle, we are continually pushing our boundaries and facing fears, giving way to awesome experiences for a more enriching life. But the path is not easy, especially when dealing with failing boat parts, since actual availability is still an issue and may delay our departure for our next big port. Join us on Panama's Isla Bastimentos, where lush jungle gives way to white sand beaches and otherworldly caves as we try to solve our latest mystery.
So the cover is off, and there is two green LEDs, one on each side.
Okay, so both lights are there.
One is flickering, though. One is flickering, the one on starboard.
Yeah, that always still we got power.
Okay.
The other one tells us that the polarity is correct if it's a green LED. I guess the first thing would be check the fuse. Nope. All right, so the fuse is probably good.
Yeah, it is.
All the way down. All right, so the next thing, I break out the voltmeter.
Okay.
If you look over on the opposite end of where that fuse is at, you got the blinking light, you got the red, the black, the blue, and the white wire.
Yeah.
I got it. Taking a voltage reading off the red and the black. See if you got 12 volts there.
Okay. 12 volt from the red all the way to the left.
A little red and a little black over where it says Sims.
13.29. Yep, yeah, I got power.
You gotta shut the power off.
Power off.
I want to take an ohm reading between the blue and the white wire.
Okay, so I guess 60.3.
You've done a source select.
Yeah.
Yes, I've done it. It doesn't show me the source. Let's turn on the instruments again. Yeah. So I go to network.
You said yeah, network and then sources.
Sources. Yep. Yeah.
Auto select. It's already highlighted at the top.
Auto select, yep. The system is ready to auto select data sources. Before starting, make sure that all connect with the power on. Okay, start.
Yeah, and if you forget something, you just go back, turn the thing on, and do the source select again. It's like a lot of times you will forget to turn on the VHF.
Complete, close.
But it's not the end of the world.
Okay, complete it.
Now I'll go back into the device list under network.
Device list.
Yeah.
Non-actory. Non-actory.
All right. X out of there and go to diagnostics.
Diagnostics. Yeah.
Bus state.
Bus state. Bus on.
Okay. Down the bottom. Then near the bottom. Bus load.
Bus load 19%. Yeah, it goes between 16 and 19.
So it should be. So it's not like you got a bad NEMA 2000 port on the NAC 3.
A bad NEMA 2000 port.
Yeah, the ohms thing checked out, so I know my data lines are okay. You got 12 volts going to it. The fuse is good. Sounds like the NAC 3 is bad to me.
The NAC 3, like the computer?
The computer is gone?
Is there any other displays?
I have three displays, yes.
Can you look at the other displays and see if they're seeing it?
I'm not, but I can. I'm now on the other display, and I'm going to network, and then device list. And no NAC 3. Everything is there except for the pilot.
It's starting to sound like the pilot's the problem.
Okay.
Continue the way I'm going. I have it set up for you to send that in to us.
Okay.
Charge you $824.
Okay.
And then either replace it. Well, of course, they fix it, it would be less money than that. But if they have to replace it, it would be $824 to replace it.
Yeah.
So now, what's the plan?
The plan, I think they're gonna call us back, see if they can facilitate, given the, you know, all the trouble we've gone through, and send us one a little sooner than next year. Well, next year is around the corners. Otherwise, I think we're going to have to buy a new one.
Right.
And and then when they replace it, have a spare, like we have spares already. It's a sad state of affair when you have to have spare for your RAM, spare for your depth sensor, spare for your autopilot, but maybe that's the way it is.
I know. Comment down below if you guys know if that's really how it is. Do people carry, I mean, I know people that carry a spare autopilot RAM.
Yeah, maybe, but you know, it's a $3,000.
Right, it's not a cheap
piece of equipment.
Right, it's not a cheap piece of equipment. So, exactly.
This is a $1,400, $1,600 retail.
Yep.
Almost $1,700. So these are like expensive items. And to have a boat full of replacement, like we're not like floating West Marine. You know what
I'm saying? That's what we're becoming.
Don't tell anybody, otherwise they're going to get on board of us and rob us. Well, we just got a phone call that we're getting a new Mac 3 computer from BNG. So we're going to take it with us to Panama so we can ship it back from there. And then once they receive it, they're going to send us a new one. That's good news.
And it's under warranty, right?
Under warranty.
Woo!
Woo-hoo! Okay. Cool. Here it is. Before taking it out, we took pictures of the way the wires are, because obviously I would not put it back. And I put labels on the wires. So hopefully we'll be able to put it back once we get it.
It's an absolutely gorgeous day today. And Red Frog Marina is on Isla Bastimentos, which is basically a big park. So there are tons of hiking trails, beaches, and so we are going to go out for a hike today and explore the island. And we're taking you guys with us.
And Yoda.
And Yoda, of course. We means Yoda.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
If you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up, leave us a comment down below, and be sure to subscribe to the channel.
Of this fern. It's amazing. Huh?
Wow.
What?
That's super cool. Oh, there he is.
This is a red or strawberry poison dart frog, and there are tons of them on this trail and throughout the island.
This is beautiful.
Hence the name of the marina and beach.
Yoda, those are not for you.
Not edible. Look at the baby star, Kristin.
Oh my goodness. He's like almost invisible.
It's like you're sleeping.
I know. Oh, I wish I could see his face. Oh my God, he's like absolutely immobile.
The sloth is so super cute with his little itty bitty face. He's just adorable. A huge thank you to our patrons. We are so grateful for your support. If you'd like real-time updates and additional content, consider joining the Harbors Unknown community on Patreon.
What a view. It is absolutely beautiful. And from here you can see other little islands.
I think we have to go this way, even though the sign says no trespass. But pretty sure that that's all gone.
Okay.
Yep.
This tree behind me is so cool. It has huge roots and it just is massive.
Look at these vines, they're incredible.
As time passes, I realize one of the things I love most about this lifestyle is change. We are able to change our backyard as often as we like, giving us new environments to explore. It's the curiosity to see what may be around the next corner, whether a beautiful view or a baby sloth, that invigorates my soul and makes me jump out of bed in the morning.
Hey, hey. Hello. Hello, pretty birdie. Fly for me.
This is Polo Beach, because this guy's name that owns it, his name is Polo. I thought we were gonna play polo, but I was wrong. Super nice place, very clean.
Yeah, they keep it super nice and clean.
This is such a beautiful spot. It's got a stretch of beach, super clean, and you can actually go swimming here. This time of year, it's really difficult to find a spot to go swimming because the waves are so strong. And then there's this super cool mangroves behind me. Really beautiful place.
So when I head back?
Yeah.
Lasagna calling my name.
Oh yeah.
We met Terry and his daughter Julie at Red Frog Marina, and they kindly invited us to go on an adventure with them. We later found out that Julie is the spearfishing national champion and has her own YouTube channel. Be sure to check out Julie Higgs on Instagram and YouTube for some epic spearfishing videos. Everyone at the marina has been so friendly. It's the first time we feel like we're experiencing the cruiser community we've heard so much about, and it has been awesome.
I have a handheld desk.
Oh yeah, that would have been handy because you can't see anything. No, unfortunately, we don't have anything. It's just kind of guesswork. Oh, there's a little house.
We're taking trail number two because trail number one was a dead end. We've got some small mangrove plants over there, which are an indicator.
Yeah, I know they have them in Panama.
Yeah, I've heard they're around.
Yeah.
I bet.
Shallow this side.
Like they're right close to us.
This is so beautiful. I believe it is.
Yeah.
There's a house over there.
¿Cómo estás?
Bien.
Bien, bien. Estamos buscando las cuevas.
Está más para arriba.
Más para arriba. Ah, ¿cuál puede ir con el barquito allá? Sí. Bien, gracias. ¿Cómo te llama usted?
Jairo.
Jairo. Yo soy Fabio. ¿Usted?
Ana Sofía.
¿Sofía?
Ana Sofía.
Ana Sofía. Oh, dos nombres, mejor. Mucho gusto. Ok, muchas gracias. ¿Cuánto falta?
al
tu vas, tú vas hacia allá en el mundo.
¿Como 5 minutos? ¿O más que 5, 10 minutos?
Yo no sé.
No sé. Okay. Bye bye.
Gracias.
Gracias.
Ciao. Muchas gracias.
Oh, they have a sign. Oh,
yes.
Hey, it's so much more rewarding when you find it on your own, right? With the help.
You're waiting to say that until we actually found it.
Yeah. Of course. There have been times when we haven't found it.
Oh, yes.
Welcome to the Bat Cave.
Yay!
Well, why don't we go ahead and hop up there and I'll lock up.
We are off to the Bat Cave.
This is so beautiful.
Make sure to keep your mouth closed when you look up.
Yeah.
Because the bats drop here and poo that stuff. Because there's a thousand of them inside the cave.
Yeah.
And last, also we have a lot of those crooked spiders inside the cave, but those spiders doesn't bite. Okay, don't have to worry about it.
Okay.
No caiman in the cave, no snake in the cave. We're gonna survive on this. This is not first time I'm gonna go in the cave.
Okay. You've got on your light already. You're prepared. Okay. Exactly.
Oh my goodness. Wow. Oh my god. Oh wow. Oh, look at them all.
Mm-hmm.
Can you
keep your mouth off the coast?
It is. Ooh, they're fighting over there.
Scorpions spider, but actually they don't bite.
Okay, but yes.
This one here, that's a crooked spider. That's a
oh, there's a lot of spiders.
Yeah. 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 Be careful when you put your hands on the
I know. Oh, there's more. Oh, there's a lot of spiders. Okay. Oh, oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh, the bad dirty see here, that's bat one, that's bat two.
Yeah.
That thing's getting here because all the way up there in the ceiling is where they live.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's about one we use for fertilizer.
Mm-hmm.
That's the best fertilizer we have.
Yeah, it's actually very valuable, right?
They're very cute, actually.
Oh, super cute. So if you can call that,
they make great pets.
Then I must be gorgeous.
Oh, right there. Now I see him.
That's a insect bat.
The bats weren't the only interesting aspect of the cave. Stalactites hung from the ceiling, creating an intricate, otherworldly environment. I've been fascinated by these structures for a long time, and we visit caves whenever we discover one is nearby. It's a setting so out of the ordinary, stimulating all senses and evoking a childlike wonder. Whenever I'm happiest, this seems to be a recurrent theme, but the real feat is finding joy in everyday simplicity.
Is that a snake? No, it's a snake. Okay.
Okay, you see that one? Right, that one? This.
Oh, that's a
shark.
Yeah. That's a
shark piece. Oh, wow. Look at that. That is cool.
We have a lot of that. That's a different size in here.
Or sometimes here where we stop sometimes, but no, actually this cave keep going.
Oh.
This cave keep going and going again.
All right, now we're going up the left-hand side. The water's gonna get really deep here.
And cold.
And cold.
The water is
up to the waist now. Okay. Oh yeah, that's cold. It's definitely cold. Oh my goodness!
Oh, I'm glad I'm not short.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, it's getting on my tiptoes.
It's getting lighter.
I'll let you guys in on a little secret. I'm a bit of a chicken. I have never been a daredevil type of person, but as I get older, I'm pushing my limits more and more, and often find when I face my fears, they were kind of silly in the first place.
Basically, don't skin your butt, stay close. All right, ready?
Yeah.
The GoPro battery died, so we will be filming on the way back, but you guys have seen all of the good stuff.
Thanks so much for watching.